Good morning and welcome to St. John the Evangelist Parish this 25th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please stand and join in singing our opening song, Seek the Lord.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord Jesus, the love of God, the gifts of the Holy Spirit be with you. Good morning. And welcome to all, especially any guests that join us on this beautiful Sunday morning. In today's gospel, we hear Jesus' generosity. Those who are first will be last. Those who are last shall be first. And so with great confidence in God's mercy, we ask forgiveness for our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. All the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts we may merit to attain eternal life. This we ask through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way and the wicked his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God who is generous in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. The word of the Lord.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to Philippians. Brothers and sisters, Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me, life is Christ, and death is gain. If I go on living in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me. And I do not know which I shall choose. I am caught between the two. I long to depart from this life and be with Christ, for that is far better. Yet that I may remain in the flesh is more necessary for your benefit. Only conduct yourselves in a way worthy of the gospel of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn and hired laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, the landowner saw others standing idle in the marketplace. He said to them, "You too go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off. He went out again around noon and around 3 o'clock and did likewise. Going out about 5 o'clock, the landowner found others still standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You two go into my vineyard." Now when it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when the first came, they thought that they would receive more, but each of them also got the usual daily wage. On receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones worked only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us who bore the day's burden and the heat." The landowner said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous? Thus the last will be first, and the first will be last." The Gospel of the Lord. Out of the Gospels comes one of my favorite quotes, the very first public words of Jesus. You might recall, Jesus said, "Repent, the kingdom of God is at hand." And when I hear those words, I think how generous, how hopeful it is for all of us sinners that the kingdom of God is here for us. And all we have to do is change our tune. All we have to do is repent, asking God's forgiveness, changing our lives. 2,000 years ago, Jesus spoke those to the crowds. What hope, what possibilities, what a great vision for the end of life. 2,000 years later, Matthew's Gospel reminds us of that hope. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Recently, on one of the Catholic radio stations this past week, I was listening and they were speaking about God's generosity. Is it really true and do we believe it? How often as we as repentant sinners of sins long ago question ourselves, does God really forgive me of that sin? It might have been multiple years of the same sin over and over and over again. Can God be that generous? And one of the questions and about that generosity, this radio program brought up this notorious gangster back in the 30s. He was a hitman for one of the great gangsters, killing many people, many of the revivals of this gangster team. And this particular day, he found himself shot right in the middle of the Chicago streets. And somebody went up to him, and before he died, he says, "Get me a priest." And sure enough, a priest shows up as he's bleeding to death on the streets of Chicago, and he asks forgiveness. The priest gives him absolution, and Chicago Tribune hears of this incident of the priest showing up at this hitman's death. And says, is it real? Will God truly forgive this notorious man who has been so violent, who's killed so many? And of course, that's a great question to ask ourselves. Do we believe in that great generosity of God's mercy if someone is truly repentant as they breathe their last? Can God? Will God? Will God forgive us? Can God forgive us? And so this is the point of today's gospel. The landowner, so generous, hiring people all day long, paying the last guy who's worked 1 hour in the cool of the evening sun, the same as those who showed up at 6 a.m. in the morning, working through the coolness of the day, the heat of the day, the thirst of the day, the hunger of the day, and now God treats them the same. We might say, like the man who worked all day, it's unfair. Give me more. If you're going to give them the same, give me more. And so as Francis Thompson in his poem, The Hound of Heaven, reminds us that God is that generous as he continually knocks on our minds, knocks on our hearts, continually inviting us in many different varied ways through today's scripture, through the generosity of friends and family. And that as we receive and trust in God's mercy, what is the challenge is that we in return give that gift to others. Every day, the priest of the church pray the liturgy of the hours, the divine office, and part of the morning prayer is praying the Zechariah's canticle, announcing the birth of John the Baptist. And Zechariah says, "The dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in the darkness of sin, to be guided into peace." And that is a message for all of us. The light of Christ, the dawn from on high, shall break upon those in darkness, all sinners, that we may be people of peace. And so today, as we hear once again of God's generosity, may we be trusting in that love. May it be an invitation for us to repent. And may we always be generous in offering welcome and forgiveness to those who have harmed us as individuals, as a church, as a society. Repent. The good news, the kingdom of God is at hand. Let us rise as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead. Trust in God's abundant generosity, we pray for the needs of all.
For Pope Francis, Archbishop Listecki, and the Church, that we may humbly accept God's gift of salvation and recognize that every day is God's gift to us, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the young people who are in religious education, especially those who are preparing for the reception of sacraments this year, that they may grow in their knowledge and love of God and in their commitment to the Christian community, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are working to aid those in need, particularly firefighters and rescue workers, that God will give them strength, wisdom, and protection from harm, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have been cheated out of their wages, that God will bring justice for those who have been defrauded and help them in their attempts to reclaim what they are justly owed, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering persecution for their faith, that God will protect them from harm and help them to give faithful witness to the gospel, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are approaching death, those with terminal illnesses, and those who care for them, that they may approach death as a gain and prefer Christ before all else, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For parishioner Frank Kloiber, who died recently, and for Richard and Lucille Matalski, Karen Green, Eileen Barwig, Nathan Hill, and Carol Flanick, for whom this Mass is said, and for those intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Gracious God, hear our prayers as we entrust in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior, forever and ever.
Amen.
Oh,
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be made acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands to the praise and glory of his name. Receive with favor, Lord, the offerings of your people, that what we profess with devotion and faith may be ours through these heavenly mysteries. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. Lift up your hearts.
Give it possible.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ. And so with the choirs of heavenly angels, we sing your praises. You are indeed holy, O Lord, you are the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time Jesus was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice once more, giving thanks. He gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord God, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. bringer to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jerome, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we pray as Jesus taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord Jesus always be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of God's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Bless those called to share in the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word. the body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
See you.
morning's announcements, there are four open hours for Eucharistic adoration. Please prayerfully consider taking part. Days and times are in the bulletin. The Respect Life Committee is looking for parishioners to bake brownies for their bake sale in 2 weeks. Please volunteer after Mass in the narthex. The Word Among Us for October is available in the narthex. Cost is $2 each. And script will be sold after all Masses this weekend.
Let us pray. Graciously raise up, Lord our God, those who renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness snares of the devil. May God rebuke him. Prince of heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking your souls. Amen. Mary, Mother of Mercy,
pray for us.
Hopefully by now you received your time and talent sheet. We ask that you fill it out and return it to the back of church as soon as possible. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Go in God's peace.